In today's market, the highest performing analog gaming keyboards can retail for nearly $200. The company DrunkDeer aims to change that with the G65, a 65% keyboard with many of the same features as the Wooting 60HE, including Rapid Trigger, all at a much lower price. This keyboard was sent out by DrunkDeer, but as usual, this will not affect the review in any way. In terms of input latency, we found in our rough testing that the G65 has approximately 4 milliseconds of latency in both default and turbo mode, which is faster than the Huntsman Mini Analog, and surprisingly the Apex Pro. It is, however, still beaten by the Wooting 60HE in both default and tachyon mode. Do take these numbers with a grain of salt, as we measure them in comparison to reference mice with known click latencies. This is a very rudimentary method and is likely prone to error, but the results appear roughly consistent with a few existing tests of keyboard input latency. At the end of the day, differences of 1, 2, or even 4 milliseconds will likely be impossible for you to notice in-game. Like the Wooting 60HE, the G65 is a Hall Effect keyboard, which means you can adjust the actuation height on the switches. As I mentioned earlier, the G65 does support Rapid Trigger, which allows you to deactivate and reactivate the switch without passing a specific actuation height, making the keyboard feel much more responsive. There is an issue with the Rapid Trigger implementation, as there seems to be a dead zone towards the bottom millimeter or so of the switch, where Rapid Trigger release distance changes depending on what angle you press the switch from. Enabling the turbo mode in the software does improve the issue to the point where it's difficult to notice in use, but that inconsistency is still present towards the very bottom of the switch. Upon disassembling the switches, I found that the springs were made out of a magnetic steel, which might be affecting the Hall Effect sensors, as they operate by detecting magnetic field strength. The Wooting, meanwhile, uses non-magnetic steel for the springs, which do not have this issue. In-game, the G65 does feel very responsive, certainly far better than any non-analog keyboard, but it does feel a tiny bit less responsive than the Rapid Trigger on the Wooting 60HE or the SteelSeries Apex Pro when set to the lowest release distance. It looks like if you want the best performance on the market, the Wooting wins. The G65 uses DrunkDeer's browser-based software, which allows you to control RGB, actuation distance, and Rapid Trigger sensitivity. According to DrunkDeer, key remapping functionality will be added in the next few weeks. Overall, the software is rather limited at the moment, especially when compared to utility, but I do find it fairly convenient to use. The switches on the G65 are Reisha Hall Effect switches. To be clear, these are not compatible with the Wooting 60HE. These switches have much less stem wobble than the Lecker switches on the Wooting and are extremely smooth. They have a relatively short spring with a 57 gram bottom out, which leads to a weaker rebound than those of the Leckers. Unlike the Lecker switches, you can't rotate them to be south-facing, but they have a longer stem which prevents interference with cherry profile keycaps. I like these switches a lot, and they feel much nicer than the Lecker switches on the Wooting. In terms of sound, however, in stock form, they do have a considerable amount of spring pinging. The G65 uses plate mount stabilizers on the Shift, Enter, and Backspace, and a PCB mount stabilizer on the Spacebar. The Shift, Enter, and Backspace have a little bit of rattle, likely owing to the slightly loose fit on the plate, but are overall quite good for a stock gaming keyboard. The spacebar, however, is perfect, with there being no rattle whatsoever even in stock form. These are probably the best stabilizers I've felt on a stock gaming keyboard. The keycaps on the G65 are cherry profile double shot PBT. These are a bit thin and don't have the most consistent legending, but they get the job done. I haven't had any issues using them. The case is made out of ABS plastic, and it's fine. Nothing special, but it feels fairly solid. The plate is aluminum, and the assembly comes with silicone dampening between the plate and PCB. In stock form, the G65 sounds rather hollow, plasticky, and pingy. There is some case foam, but it's not very dense, and doesn't seem to help with the hollowness all that much. Take a listen to the sound for yourself. The G65 features flexible feet to emulate the soft cushion feel of a gasket mount keyboard, and I have to say I don't really think it succeeds, as it still feels quite harsh. The overall typing experience on the stock G65 is above average for a gaming keyboard, but I think the stock Wooting does still beat it out due to the better sound dampening and lack of spring ping. The G65 is actually fairly easy to disassemble and mod. The switches are hot swappable, making them very easy to lube. Lubing the springs is especially important as it eliminates the metallic pinging. If you take the keycaps off, you'll see that the plate is fastened to the case with 12 Phillips head screws. I'm gonna put tape on the back of the PCB, as it tends to make keyboards sound a bit poppier. I'm not gonna mod the stabs today because they're already fairly good, plus I'm lazy and there are already many good stab tutorials. In an attempt to get rid of the hollowness, I'm going to add some case dampening. I use a Noico car sound dampening mat because I have a lot of those and it gives the keyboard a bit more weight to it, but you can use polyfill, a silicone pour, or any kind of foam. I also dampened the spacebar with some Noico, which would give it a cleaner and deeper sound. I tried using Poron switch pads like I did on the Wooting, but I found that it gave the G65 a really mushy feel for some reason, so I scrapped that plan. DrunkDeer recently released an aluminum case for the G65. I have not had the opportunity to test it out, but it looks quite promising. I did the O-ring gasket mod to improve the sound, just like I did on the Wooting. I'll leave Bad Seed Tech's Wooting 60HE tutorial in the description for reference if you want to try it. And here's the final modded sound test. Now how does it compare to my $400 case swapped Wooting? The G65 doesn't sound bad at all, and personally I think the switches are a bit cleaner sounding than those on the Wooting. With an aluminum case, it's very possible that the typing experience on the G65 could surpass that of the Wooting, but that remains to be seen. The G65 is a very good gaming keyboard. It has a reasonable stock typing experience and is fairly easy to mod. Additionally, the performance is very good for the price, though it doesn't quite match that of the Wooting 60HE. At a price of around $120, the G65 is the best performing gaming keyboard in its price range that we have tested. If you're unwilling to spend more than $130 on a keyboard, I can give the G65 a very solid recommendation. Of course, if you are willing to spend more, the Wooting 60HE is still my main recommendation, as the performance is still noticeably better. There are also other more affordable options on the horizon, such as the Polar 65 and the Mod 007HE, but we have yet to test those.